What's the dumbest thing you've done out of horniness? When I was deployed to Kenya on an exercise, I had sentry duty at like 3 a.m. Naturally, I decided that a wank would make the situation better. There were people about but at a distance, so thought no one will know. After about 5 minutes I started hearing people laughing. What I failed to realize in the floodlight behind me was projecting my little escapade like some sort of fricked up shadow puppet show. Have two neodymium magnets stuck onto my dong, which was then flaccid. I learned my lesson. Don't play with super strong magnets while frisky. I got lucky and didn't lose any skin. I'm never putting magnets on a flaccid dong ever again. Jesus Christ in heaven, no. Jerked off in the top bunk of the camper while everyone was sleeping. Definitely rocked the thing a little, and then I soiled a dishcloth that made a cameo during breakfast co-starring my grandpa, who threw it straight in the trash. I was 13. Gramps knew what was up. At 13 I was camping with a buddy and his family, and there was a girl at a neighboring camp that was very flirty. We played truth or dare around the campfire. Practically a metal drum. She dared me to touch the metal and she'd flash me her nether region. I did it. She did it. Next day my whole palm was a blister. Not from the fire pit, though. I donated blood in high school because a beautiful girl convinced me to. Not really that dumb, but I've never stopped getting emails asking to donate blood more. That's like donating your boner because you got a boner mayo. Friend of mine was at a bar and was chatting with two girls who he was going to hook up with. Threesome. But in his frisky drunken state, he walked out the bar and made his way to his FWB. On the way, he really needed to crap. So he stopped off at a park with a lake and proceeded to do the deed. He then realized he didn't have toilet paper, so he grabbed some leaves which had thorns on them. He wiped and scratched his butt and balls bad, then fell into the water with his trousers down. From a potential threesome, to being soaked, half covered in his own crap and with a scratched butt and balls at 3 a.m. in a park with his pants down. Friend of mine. Not sure about dumbest, but there was this piece series in Hungarian that I was really into, and I could get the gist of the storylines from the events of the video, but I decided I want to know what they're actually saying. To that goal I downloaded the videos, separated the sound and saved them as MP3s, then uploaded them to a website for automated translations with the language set to Hungarian English. Result was essentially Google Translate English, which I rephrased into what I imagined would be a more natural way to express the same things in English. Then I wrote a Dart sub file for the P videos so that I in the future could watch them and also understand the dialogue. That's a lot of effort driven by a little frisky. One has to respect your technological wit though. Fricked a girl in the back room of a gas station, then freezer, then in the bathroom and broke the sink. I got fired the next day. Funny part is, my dad was the manager of another gas station in the same chain. He knew. Once walked into my bathroom during a party to find my friend Fatboy fricking a girl who was sitting on my counter. They separated the sink from the wall and cabinet. Had to recall kit after he cocked it. My girlfriend at the time had messaged me at about midnight. We were both in a frisky mood. At this point in time she still lived at home with strict Catholic parents, so we needed to come up with a plan. Her parents were asleep at this point. I'd drive an hour down to see her, sneak in through her window, spend the night, and then sneak and hide in her bedroom closet when her parents woke the next morning until they both left for work. Then I could just walk out the front door and go home. So I drive an hour down, park my car on the street behind theirs, just in case they'd recognize my car when leaving the next morning, and walk all the way to her fence, hop it and crawl in through the window. We don't immediately go for it but read for a bit. We were both big book nerds, and then watch a movie. By the time the second movie comes around, we decide to start getting handsy and then clothes are coming off. To the point I'm down to my boxers and she's just down to her panties and I'm on top of her. That's when I hear a scoff from the other side of the room. We both look over to find her mom standing in the doorframe. Completely shocked to find what she did. She said she got up for a glass of water and heard the TV going and wanted to check in, but as she got closer was hearing, well, us. My girlfriend gets pulled out of the room and her mom talk in the hallway. Meanwhile I'm scrambling to find where the rest of my clothes have gone to but can't seem to find any of it. She usually had a ton of clothes thrown all over the floor and chairs in her room. Mom comes back in and tells me she's gonna wake up the father. At this point I start thinking maybe I won't need to find my clothes since I'll be dead. Dad comes in and the look on his face could have melted paint off a wall. He talked to me about how I disrespected him, his daughter, God and myself. And I wound up getting lectured by her father like this for about 20 minutes while I'm just sitting there in my boxers. I find my clothes. He lets me out the front door and tells me he doesn't think he would handle seeing me again very well. And I walk back to my car and drive an hour back home at like 4 a.m. Our relationship wasn't the same after that. She told me her parents were willing to give me a second chance but I was too stubborn and embarrassed and there were other things that weren't clicking in the relationship that I just decided to end it shortly after. I won't need to find my clothes since I'll be dead made me laugh out loud. I was 13 and at parents' friend's house. Bathroom, studying my erection, as one does. Had it wrapped in toilet paper. I honestly don't remember why. Standing straight up, robed in white. Got walked in on by a female member of that family. Yeah, looks at me, at it, at me, reacts and backs out. I swear there was mild amusement in her face. I remember poking my dong through toilet paper and wondering if that's what sex felt like. Mayo. Running 30 minutes to her house at around 1 a.m. By the time I got there she was asleep and didn't respond. Long walk home with sore legs and blue balls. Sorry yours didn't turn out well. Operating on the logic that I needed the miles anyway, I ran 40 minutes to a guy's hotel room at 9 p.m. on a weeknight. Proceeded to have sex in the shower, on the bed, against a wall. Thankfully the guy drove me home after so I didn't have to run back. 10/10 would do again in a heartbeat. Haha. Back when Wi-Fi was pretty new and there were many networks that had no password, you could connect to someone's random internet. I was a super frisky teen, maybe 18 because I was driving at that point. I really wanted to watch pee at that exact moment and knock one out. I drove slowly through a neighborhood until an unsecured network popped up on my laptop and I beat off super fast. Pretty ridiculous now that I think about it. Carjacking. I was 19 and really drunk. Visiting a friend of a friend in Kamloops. Was about to hook up with a girl when she reminded me to use protection. I didn't have any. Ran about 200 yards to the corner store in my boxers to buy some then ran back. Then got whiskey dong and passed out on the couch alone. Yeah. The power of boners is sometimes fickle. Told a guy to, you know, blow his load on my chest. Then wiped it up with one of those bags that come with a bottle of Crown Royal. Then he politely put the bottle back in the bag and gave it to his roommate. That's gotta be one luxurious velvety wipe down, though. Used Hershey's on my PP. Thought it would be similar to lube but just chocolate. It was a sticky situation to say the least. What? I was 16 years old and this girl named Chandra lived about 60 minutes away by car. She told me she would suck my dong on the phone so logically I snuck out and hopped on my BMX bike and rode about 2 hours in the middle of the night with no lights. I had no Google Maps just navigating by sense of boner and hormones. Got to her house and she had some magic mushrooms dried out. We ate them and had sex and walked to a nearby park. It was magical and fairy tale like. We had a wonderful time. I left ecstatic that I had sex and was tripping the whole ride home. I felt as if I was a pirate for some reason lol. Got home at 5 a.m. and my dad started making coffee at 5:30. I didn't get any sleep and went to school like nothing happened. Just navigating by sense of boner and hormones. That cracked me up and was actually rather poetic. When I was 20 my parents and younger brother had gone away for the weekend so I invited my girlfriend over to our house for a night of passion. I had this great idea of dragging a mattress onto the roof so we could make love under the stars. I dragged the mattress through a second floor window and up a sloping section of the roof. The roof was corrugated metal with bolts sticking out in the corrugations every meter or so. As I finally got the mattress on the top of the roof I started slipping down the sloping roof in bare feet. I slipped about 6 or 7 meters and stopped at the gutter on the first floor. But I had also slipped over the bolts which had ripped open the soles of my feet and blood was pee out of my feet all over the roof. My girlfriend, who was watching me, saw the blood and went and got a few towels and I wrapped up my feet. I then climbed off the roof and she drove me to the closest hospital to have my feet sewn up. Having anesthetic injections into the soles of my feet remains the most painful experience of my life. We went home with my feet sewn and wrapped up and still had sex. I told my mum what happened the next day as the mattress was still on the roof and the blood was still there. We never spoke of it again. I'm 48 now and haven't thought about that for a long time. Having anesthetic injections into the soles of my feet remains the most painful experience of my life. We went home with my feet sewn and wrapped up and still had sex. Priority my man. I asked my friend if she's down to have sex, knowing that I'm about to ruin everything between us. And well, she surprisingly said yes. When I was a teenager, my dummy hot GF at the time had let me titty frick her and I couldn't get the experience out of my head at all. But to try and stimulate and simulate, I found some water balloons and filled them with hot water and put them in a tissue box to emulate cleavage. It looked pretty decent and I got too riled up and dumb to think any of this through all the way. So I bring it in the bedroom and start at it, with no lube. Not that this would have helped. I hadn't thought ahead at all. So after about a second or two of building up static on my pubes with my baby arm, the balloons popped all over my freaking bed, like I was supposed to on those balloon titties. So I am sitting there with a soggy tissue box and two busted balloons on my deflating half-erect dong, drenched bed, idiotic feeling in my head, and no nut. I slept on the floor for like 2 days because my bed was just soaked. Luckily my parents didn't see. They certainly would have thought I wet the bed like a child. This is probably pretty low stakes on the grand scheme of things, but whenever this question pops up, this is the thing that immediately springs to mind. In the days when VHS video cameras were not common, I borrowed one, filmed myself jerking off, then watched the video, and jerked off again as I watched myself jerking off. Self-love to the maximum. Patrick Bateman would be proud. Was having sex with an ex for about an hour after getting a sudden bout of second wind. She suddenly asked me to put it in her butt, and I was so overcome with shock and horniness that I came everywhere while farting my brains out. I never did get to put it in her butt. I did not see that turn coming. Ditched the rubber. Didn't have one handy and I was so frisky I just needed that dong. A few weeks later the person calls me and informs me they've tested positive for HIV and that they had it when we had sex, so I should get tested. I must have been insanely lucky cause I tested negative then and still tested negative last time I got tested, but that scare a few years ago taught me the importance of always having protection with you. Hugh, congratulations. I guess now is the time to tell my own coconut story. Surprisingly, this happened before all the coconut sucker tifus started coming up. So I was 16, and on vacation in Mexico with my mom, stepdad and younger sister. Like with most family vacations, we're all sharing a room, and I'm bunking with my sister. Between this and all the activity, I hadn't been able to crank one out, and that, combined with seeing tons of hot women in bikinis, was enough to drive teenage me nuts. Anyways, one afternoon, I'm walking by the pool and I see someone selling coconuts for 50 pesos, so I asked my mom if I could get one and she says yes. The way they cut it was enough to reveal a layer of flesh covering the top, and a little bit on the bottom so it could stand up on a table properly. I think this is why other people managed to cut their dong, because they drilled a hole into the side and got cut on the tough, sharp outer layer. As I'm drinking it, I look at how stretchy it is on the top, and I poked my finger through. Then it hit me. Oh my god. It kinda feels like a vagina. I should frick this thing. The skin is a little bit dense, but if scrape it, it will feel fricking great. So I'm drinking it quickly now, and my mom is trying to tear off bits of the top, and I'm swatting her hand away from it. Eventually, I finish drinking it, and so I run up to the room, go into the washroom and start preparing it, and I go to town. Holy crap. It felt incredible. Like 10/10, what fuck again. So as I'm doing this, I hear a knock on the room door. First thought, where the frick do I put this coconut with a vagina shaped hole in the top? There wasn't anywhere to hide it that completely out of sight, like a drawer or in a cabinet, but I saw a ledge under the sink and I put it in there as far back as possible. All I can think as they prepare for dinner is please don't find it, please don't find it, but all is well. They have forgotten about the coconut. Until that evening, we're all sitting watching a movie when my mom asks me, my name, where is that coconut? Crap man, don't blow this. I threw it out. What was I supposed to say? In the washroom under the sink? But I fricked it, so don't eat it. What? Why? It was like $5. I wanted to eat that. I'm sorry. I felt bad at this point, but least they didn't know. But then, the next morning I wake up to my stepdad saying, "Why is the coconut in the washroom?" I thought he said threw it out. Why would he lie? Frick, 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 frick. All I could muster was please don't eat it before I buried myself in the blanket. To this day I don't know if they knew I fricked the coconut, or if they thought I was just being incredibly selfish and wanted to eat it myself. TLDR. I became the family coconut sucker. I didn't hurt my dong like most coconut suckers. I just hurt my pride. All I got is, if you're frisky, have a dong and a nice soft coconut. Make a large hole and frick it, but if anyone tries to enter, throw it out the window. An old friend of mine cheated on his girl frequently. When they broke up, I hooked up with her. Turns out they didn't exactly break up. She tried to kill herself. He tried to kick my butt. I lost my friends and we all got an STD. Crazy really does make you crazy. What a crap show in one comment. When I was younger I had no P access, so I logged on to COD offline, shot the image of boobs on the wall and busted a nut. Ha 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 ha. Whoa. Licked a girl out in a Dublin laneway behind some dumpster bins because she was super keen and I was frisky. As it happens, afterwards I tripped and fell on a rat that was scurrying across the lane. Had crap and blood smeared up my arm. It was a crazy night. Somehow ended up staying at her brother's house that night. I miss backpacker life. What the actual frick? That reads like a movie. When I was 17 I biked 110 kilometers, 68.3 miles, on a crappy bike to hook up with a girl I got to know at a festival. All that for 3 minutes of fun and chlamydia. I don't remember how old I was, somewhere around 16 I think. I had an MP3 player and a computer. The computer was in my shared bedroom. I wanted to wank to some hentai, but didn't want to disturb anyone else living with me. So I took a short hentai clip I had downloaded and converted it to audio only. Then, I put it on the MP3 player so I could wank in the closet, sort of also my bedroom, didn't have a computer but it did have my bed, and got ready for a nice thrashing of my dong. For some strange reason, there were random audio blasts every second or two in the hentai audio. It would be girl moaning with random screeches of sound. So I googled how to edit audio, downloaded Audacity, and basically lowered the volume of those sound blasts. Then I proceeded to have my right hand give me joy. TLDR. I learned how to download video, convert to audio, and remove audio glitches just because I wanted to jerk off to a hentai girl moaning in private. Is this dumb? Number. Is it pathetic? Yes. The power of boners can sometimes grant a lucky man a new skill. Bit late to the party, but 17-year-old me was out at night with my friends drinking. The girl I liked was wearing a ridiculously short dress and I got a glimpse of her panties. Instantly got hard and needed to relieve myself, but I couldn't do it outside in case someone caught me. So I snuck round the corner and climbed a scaffolding and lay down 3 floors up where no one could see me. Shot my load over the side of the scaffold, then joined back up with my friends as if nothing had happened. Multiple instances of unprotected sex with a girl I knew in college who slept around. And in most of those I didn't pull out. I'm surprised I'm not a father. Had a Marine pretend to be my brother to take me off base. Got a hotel room and went at it. Thank God we weren't caught. Also slept with a gay guy. Drunk as heck on a neighbor's trampoline. Honestly, probably too many come to mind, but picking this one. Took off work at lunch. Drove 30 minutes to meet a girl who was a mortician and we fricked in the break room of the funeral home with caskets in the viewing room right outside the room. They were not empty. If those people knew what was going on, they'd be rolling over in their graves right now. I masturbated with toothpaste when I was a teenager. I was using different soaps, shampoos, and conditioners. I thought it would work really well after I worked it into a bubbly lather. It did, but it was super minty on my junk. 1/10 experience overall, would not recommend. This is the kind of stupid, funny crap I'm looking for. I thought of swallowing my own CM out of curiosity. Then before masturbating, all I could think was, I am gonna swallow the crap out of my CM. And I didn't. The moment you CM, you think, you, why would I swallow my CM? Drove to a dong app that promised that we would hook up in a back house, but instead made me walk through a dark alley with a dead cat on the side, and ended up hooking up outside in the backyard with a jacket laid on the grass as our bed. Only lasted 2 minutes, then kicked me out BC he realized that his Ring cameras were on. Jesus, what an experience. Got a total stranger to come dong me in my car bareback and CM inside of me. Could have turned into a real bad situation. Planning my whole night around the possibility of going over to his house, even though we made no plans, but assuming I would end up there and then not ending up there and being bummed about it. Bounce my tea on purpose. In class. In front of my crush. We've been dating for 6 years. I love happy endings. I served in the military a few years ago. One of the times I was on guard in the watchtower, I felt so frisky, so I rubbed one like a maniac in a freaking watchtower on a duty. In England we call these wanking booths. You are probably not the only one. So I had this closet at my grandma's. I like to feed the geese in when I was young, like 8 or 9 I was in elementary school. I commandeered some porno magazines from my older brothers and I always went to this closet where I had those pornos hidden to crank one out every now and again. My grandma said she was cooking dinner, so what a great time to go feed the geese in this closet I had. Here I was, dong in my hand, going to town on my little guy. Next thing I know, grandma busted in the closet telling me dinner is ready. I instantly start saying I wasn't doing anything and proceed to start crying my eyes out. Meanwhile, my older brothers in the living room knew exactly what had happened and was dying laughing the whole time. A very traumatizing experience. No one ever wants their grandma to see them cranking one out. I snuck a boy over when I was in high school. I shared a room with my little sister. She was probably like a third grader. She woke up, but I convinced her that she was dreaming, so she never told our parents. It's been like 9 years and she's never brought it up. Maybe I'll bring it up at Christmas this year, haha. Masturbated in the shower, knowing fully well my whole family is home. It was really good, but later I realized that our walls might not be as soundproof as I thought. Oops. Dumb and lonely in college. My roommate's BF had friends over. His friend that I literally just met said, "Wanna freak?" We freaked. Having sex. She's on top. She tells me to spank her while she writes. I spank. Harder, she asks. I complied. Harder, she yells. Looking to meet the C requirement apparently desired for this spank, I prepare a big wind up. This was gonna be the spank to end all spanks. With a spring-loaded arm, I launch all the force I can muster into action. However, she got cold feet. Seeing the wind up caused her to flinch out of the way. Her retreat resulted in what I can only describe as 100 pounds of pressure self-inflicted directly into my ballsack via mega slap. I slept with my boss after we both got drunk on a biz trip. Who knew she'll end up clingy-af, and I had to leave the company just to get my life and career back on track. I was partying in Tokyo and decided to go back to my Airbnb. I realized the trains weren't running when I left, so I started to drunkenly wander around the streets when I had a guy approach me and told me he had women available to have sex with. So, me being drunk and frisky, I followed him through many sketchy dark alleys with men posted in every corner to a back hotel room. I sat in a private room with a binder full of different women's pictures. I chose one, handed over 10,000 yen, and went to her another back room where a woman was waiting that looked nothing like the one I chose. I didn't care since I already gave money and we started getting down to it. She pulled out what felt like a plastic bag that you'd get groceries in and started giving me a blowjob. It obviously wasn't doing much, so she said for vaginal sex it'd be another 10,000 yen. I handed it over and she still used the plastic bag. It felt terrible, but I wanted to finish and she kept telling me to hurry up. Through much pressure and time she was able to get another 30,000 yen. And that's how I spent $500 to have plastic bag sex with a Japanese H and leave blue balled as all heck. It just felt like a plastic bag because your genitals were pixelated. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.